Ghana Talks Business.
Now let's look at the issue of the retail sector.
Okay.
Let's say for the past probably 10 years, we've got an expansion of the retail sector. We saw the likes of ShopRite, Game, or just come in. The mall concept also crept in, starting with our Crown Mall, the ANC Mall, the Achimota Mall, and it keeps going and going. In a recent publication, I think these retail operators have come out to say that it's quite a struggle.
Mm-hmm.
Then we said, oh, the middle class is growing, Ghana started, you know, oil and all that and all that. Do you think they were over-optimistic?
I wouldn't say they were optimistic. Seriously, how would you decide to penetrate a certain market?
Mm.
You have to do your analysis. And if you remember some years back, the news all over the world was Africa rising.
Mm.
You turn on CNN, Africa rising.
Africa is rising.
Yes. Newsweek, Africa rising. Do you understand? And Ghana was at the forefront of this rising thing. And things have not happened as they should. And I can tell you there are some people, even in the financial sector, which is supposed to be the core of the sectors in Ghana, who have not gotten a raise in about 3 years. So if you are in the middle class, and you have not gotten a raise in 3 years, you are not going to spend money.
And looking at all the inflation and all that is going on, and obviously your disposable income drops.
Yes, and the economy has somewhat shrunk a little bit. So people are holding on to their cash. So instead of me going to the mall, maybe to purchase a designer shirt, I will probably go to Tudu to get something that looks good.
So do you see a situation where these retailers are probably going to pack up and say we're leaving, or they should just hang in there and hope that things...
Oh, I don't think they will just pack up and leave. Because the investment that they've made, they have to make a return. And for me, I also think that the Ghanaian economy is going to, get better.
Okay.
We just have to get some of the fundamentals right. And the conversation has already started.
Okay.
Before, you probably might not have the some CEOs or people in the financial industry talking about what the government is not doing right. Now it's all over the place.
That's right.
You have the vice presidential candidate of the opposition party also bringing out some issues. So the government will eventually sit up.
Okay.
It might take a while. Because sometimes when you go down, the only other place you can go, the only option for you is to go up. You cannot go down further. Do you understand how? So for me, the mall concept has passed on in the advanced countries.
And now we are now getting it. Is it in at a good time? Do you see it progressing to the point it did in the Western world before it probably starts tipping over? Or that the informal sector trading is still going to hold its strength against this formalized kind of retail?
Well, for me, they are going to thrive.
Okay.
Remember, we have the BRICS countries: Brazil, Russia, India, China, and then Singapore. You know, the next wave was supposed to be the MINT. Mexico, Indonesia, Nigeria, and Turkey.
Okay.
You understand, huh? But the oil prices has
slumped them down a little bit.
And there are others also in place in which most African countries are going to follow through. And as your middle class increases, the propensity for people to spend is there. So just for people to feel good about themselves, they will need those. Remember when the Accra Mall started some years back, nobody even envisioned Accra, the greater Accra region, having about three malls.
Four malls now.
Yes. Yeah. And now they are building the biggest one in Kumasi. For a while, it's going to serve the northern sector. But if the economy improves, there is more likelihood that either Kumasi will have another mall or two, or it will have to expand and go to Sunyani. And then Takoradi, and probably Tamale. So that is what is going to happen. I don't think the economy is going to be tanking like it is now.
Okay.
Things will turn around.
So you've got some hope for the retail sector to actually, as it were, the formalized retail sector to actually bounce back.
Yes.
And so if I'm in a retail business and in the informal sector, you think it's a good time for me to be in?
Yes. Some of the business strategy is you enter when everybody does not want to.
Yes. Yes. So
before you realize you've taken up the market.
The market, that's right.
Let's take this, the mobile network operators in Ghana. There was an analysis done by one of these renowned organizations in the US in the late 90s. And they just based everything on the average income of the Ghanaian based on CIA's information. And the analysis was, it's not good for you to go and do mobile telephony
business in Ghana.
Yes. But now, the players who came in and started, they are reaping the benefits.
MTN is gone, isn't it?
Yes.
Because Space Phone then was there.
You understand. And it's going to be extremely difficult for even some of the American firms to penetrate. Unless, of course, they will just come and take over one of the big three and then they move on from there.
From there.
So whether we like it or not, Africa is going to be the next wave of development.
Thank you very much, Mr. Kwaku Dua Berchie, for joining us on Ghana Talks Business. We'll have you another time.
Thank you.
Well, we've been speaking to Mr. Kwaku Dua Berchie on Ghana Talks Business, and we're going to have him here again.